All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back once again here to the StarLadder Star Series Season 14. Our match between E-Frag and G2 is about to conclude here over on Cash, our third and final map. The strike back coming out here from the members of E-Frag to take the second map back over on Inferno. And now we're going to head over here on a Cash. Another very even map for both of our teams. But the night from just concluding. Once again, my name is Blue. Jeremy's Meta's today. And Meta's going to think of going into this map.
I think myself and a lot of other people are very surprised we're even here. I mean, that's no disrespect to EFRAG, they're a very good team. But G2, hot off their performance at the Major, which you have touched on a couple times, in particular Fox. Looking a bit lost on Inferno at points, and it's important to take into account as well that neither of the previous maps, Dust and Inferno, were blowouts. They're both 16-13, right? They both went down to the wire. I just feel like G2 Kingwin, maybe not 100%, and EFRAG have been performing pretty damn strong. And Cash is a map, as you said, both these teams pretty strong on. Recently, Kingwin have beat the likes of VP on Cash, and VP on Cash is pretty formidable. So, but EFRAG have a fantastic record on this map, so it really could go either way.
And to begin the pistol round here, ladies and gentlemen, G2 just go right for the mid take right off the bat. Some more play going to come in from A main as well. There's no defense from E-Frag there at all, so they're going to be able to waltz right in and take control of that site. Some more resistance coming in from middle. We've got one player playing for the chuck angle, but Rain's going to push that and take down NKL. So now it's wide open. It's basically an open book at this point here, but two kills being struck in back here by the members of E-Frag. Rain's able to pick up an additional one, so this leaves it into a 2-on-3 for the potential retake from E-Frag. But now one more is going to get stricken down, and it's just Dreamer trying to hold this off at this point. Already stuck outside of A main, so they're going to close that out, and that's a D going to be the pistol run, going by the way of G2 once again here on map number 3.
Absolutely. I'm just curious, guys. Those of you saying that one of our mics is echoing, is it the American or the NA caster, or is it the European caster? That's going to help us figure that out.
I think they might be trolling us. Gonna be honest.
That's also possible, but I've seen it a number of times now. It's just if it's my mic that's screwed up, I'll try and fix it for you.
I don't hear it on my end, so if anything, it's probably my audio board being wonky, but like I said, I don't think it's that big of a deal.
So alrighty.
If a producer or an admin comes and yells at us about it, we'll fix it, but I'm going to assume that it's a non-issue for most people at this current point in time.
Alrighty, well, here we go. Into this round, we progress through. G2 Kingwin, after winning that first, obviously with the buy-up, with the P90s and such, are going to try and hammer this down. And so far, so good. Just then, Kale remains. He's got 5 HP, of course. E-Frag also committed into this round with pistols and armor. And only one of those remains. So, solid start for G2 Kingwin, but we have seen this in the previous two maps, and things have gone quite awry for them.
So they're going to pick up that round once again, and it's going to be a pretty swift closeout coming into that one, so not a whole lot of damage being done. Again, they don't get any kills at all, to be completely honest, from the side of EFRAG, so going into this third round, no strike back at all, and this is going to be great in the long run. When you look at G2's economy, this is going to be a really good opportunity for them to build it up. Even heading into that gun round, we can see some guns being saved here from the previous rounds. It's just a whole lot of money that can be stacked up off of that, and obviously if that first gun run goes their way, they're going to be sitting on a whole big pile of cash here just because of how cleanly so far these anti-ecos have gone, and I imagine this one to be no exception to that rule.
Now the frag's just rocking on down, and E-Frag, I mean, you can understand why they go for the aggression through mid there. It's really their only chance of getting any kills down, and they did pick up two, in fairness, but again, G2, Kingwin just blocking it out, getting the frag. Streamer's got the AK-47. For E-Frag, and he is residing in garage. He's been spotted and frag from Maikelele. And here comes the buy from E-Frag. It's not going to be fantastic. There's not going to be an open play. They simply can't afford one. And we'll include FAMAS just to accommodate more grenades, which are so crucial on the CT side of Cash.
So now we're going to get into that gun round. Obviously, as we've seen before here too, two FAMAS is being brought into play, but that is going to allow for a lot more utility from the side of E-Frag here. The Molly sitting over on the spyleadeR could be very useful indeed, but he's going to use it very early on to smoke the boost spot, and not actually going to fully cover it at this point. Nonetheless, G2's not even going to use it here. They're just getting ready to set up for smokes on an A main, and again, they've left this site fairly open in terms of its overall player positions. It's only going to be NKL for the most part that's here to defend it. They're really expecting a push middle, but that's not the case at all. NKL is going to be the only player alive. He somehow escapes with that frag, but it's quickly traded out by Fox. The counter boost is going to come in, so they'll open a very quick flank up from within side of A main, and Bubble's actually doing a good job of distracting these players too. He's going to pick up an additional kill over here onto Fox, and this A main push may catch them completely off guard. Nobody's looking this direction, killing the bomb planter. He's going to pop out, should be able to take down Maikelele. SpyleadeR found another kill, and this round's over for the most part. It's just Jkaem hiding back over here inside a quad, and he's working a 1-on-4 at this point. Great retake. Honestly, didn't even let G2 get the take before they could even get the plant there, and E-Frag immediately strike right back and get control.
And it was crucial they did just that, because as we mentioned before, you know, going for the force buy on pretty low economy, not looking too fantastic. If you lose that, you're looking at 5-6-0 maybe for G2 Kinguin, and they're the kind of team that can't just run away with a lead of that kind of magnitude. So it's important E-Frag pulled that back, but they've got to keep the momentum going forward. G2 Kinguin are going to have Dennis with the AWP, which is always interesting to see. He had a pretty good spawn for B side. I'm not sure if that was factoring into their decision there. Okay. The smoke is pretty much going to screen his vision anyway, so he's not going to get much done for the foreseeable future.
It's actually going to end up kind of screwing him over, though, because now it's allowed Fox to come in and pick up not only that kill, but he gets a very nice one-tap headshot over here on a bubble to take him down as well. So two kills, B-site's an open book once again, and we've got the presence in middle, which again, there's been a big reliance on that, but Victor's very slow on that reaction. Jacob's going to be able to take down one player. Victor does find the trade, but could have saved his teammate potentially because of how long it did take that kill to pan out there, so... That's going to be G2 getting themselves onto the B side. They'll get the plant going here. And again, with just how split up the final two members of E-Frag are, I don't even think we'll see an attempt on the retake. Just going to sit back and look for exits.
Yeah, exit saw is pretty important. And obviously keeping those weapons as well, as you say. Don't want to be just throwing them into the grinder, throwing away that economy, burning that money. The problem is, though, that Victor positioned in such a forward place there for the entry frag, at the exit frags, I should say, gets picked off and... Well, there you go. The money has been burned. Just on NKL, he should be able to save this weapon for himself. But G2 Kinguin have now broken E-Frag again.
Yeah, there's nobody near him, so obviously we'll see NKL make it out. But again, that's going to be the only big gum that we'll have going into this next round, of course. Where beyond this, maybe with the exception... Actually, they should still be able to buy a little bit here, so they're still going to be able to go in for another buy. The only exception to this is going to be spyleadeR, but... Utility-wise, unfortunately, isn't going to be the best here. They get the smokes to work with here, so everybody's got a smoke in their pocket, but in terms of flashes and whatnot for a retake, it's going to be very visible, so they have to try and hold this off right from the beginning of the round. Otherwise, if they let G2 get control of a site, it's going to be very hard to retake it after that.
Yeah. So, these are the kind of situations where E-Frag maybe need to be a bit more aggressive. Maybe need to go for the peaks, and in doing so, Dennis is just there on point with the AWP. You're expecting pop flashes maybe through onto some of these sites. Bubble's in a great position. He's trying to spam through the wall. Makaleli's down to three. Any kind of shot and he's dead. A gust of wind would take him down at this point. Finally goes down. But then Jacob catches Bubble reloading. So the ebbing and flowing continues. And G2 Kinguin have a 3-on-3. And it's probably in their advantage as well. I mean, typically it is in the T hands, but especially when you consider the weapons that are in play as well. This forces CTs to stack that little bit thinner.
Look at Dennis, though, getting this flank opened up. That should be an easy kill on the NKL. That's going to find this one. And they've even fallen back now, too, because of just how empty the A site has appeared to have been. What they haven't scouted out as of yet is going to be spyleadeR, though, and he could be the throw out of the way here. The flash comes in. He's going to take down both of those players from inside of A main. And now, again, it's turned the tables once more, and it's all going to be at the hands of Dennis trying to clutch this out. He's got 30 seconds, a semi-decent amount of time given the situation and the current positions of the remaining players from E-Frag, but he's got to go huge here. That flash, not the best start to it, as unfortunately bounces off at the wrong angle. He's going to work his way in. Seeing if he can catch spyleadeR loud as hell as he works his way in here as well. So he knows he's inside, but he can't find that kill. Spyleader's going to jump out, now armed with an AK, shuts him down, and E-Frag will indeed strike back with another round.
Solid round. I'm not expecting that either. You know, when Dennis gets that frag from behind, you're thinking this is over. This is just G2 Kinguin cruising towards the next round at 5-1 in the lead. Not the case. E-Frag hold on for dear life. This forces G2 Kinguin's hand into a deagle. That being said, it is... becoming more and more popular as the headshots continue to land. So Jacob definitely can get work done there. And looking for a couple moments like they could have pushed A aggressively. Instead, though, pretty much standard. Bubble lands the op shot onto Fox. That's pretty significant. It shuts down that B play. And now the rest of G2 Kinguin situated around the A side.
Great nade, though, comes out once again for the CTs, completely decimates Makalele's and Jacob's health pools there, down to 52 and 41. So another great start to the round for E-Frag once again. And G2 trying to figure out exactly how they want to take this forward. They've even gone for this little mini boost here just inside of A main. Just try and see if they can catch any players boosted up on Big Red or even up on top of Upper, but they're not going to catch anything. So a little bit fidgety from G2. They don't really have a whole lot of security in going for this. So they're going to move Dennis over here towards mid, which there hasn't been a whole lot of play from these guys. We've only seen it 1 to 2 rounds now, and E-Frag have been so keen on defending middle just in the event that this happens. They put so much focus on that. They had one player by White Box and one behind the sandbag, so they really wanted to make sure they could hold that and then not being able to throw them off. Victor, thankfully, is going to hold that off. Successful. successfully, and then we'll see Rain pick up a trade kill. But Dreamer back over here, still playing by the forklift too. He's going to find one more, and indeed picks up an additional one before being shut down by Rain. But at the end of the day, not going to matter. Leaves only one player left alive from G2, and Viktor will be able to easily close him back out to give E-Frag their third point.
That's a key word in the end, really, easily. That was a very comfortable, confident round from E-Frag. Get the opening pick, courtesy of Bubbles AWP, and then from there on in, it just funneled G2 Kinguin into a bit of a desperate situation. So, I was expecting that we could see like a full-on eco, so they could get a solid buy next round with maybe an AWP, but the double nades through mid from Viktor. In fact, I think it was just Viktor that threw the grenade and tapped just beforehand, so he got the kill outright. And with no Kevlar there, of course, those grenades doing significant damage. What a one-tap that is as well to Rain. G2 Kinguin looking to slide out of this round as well.
Spyleader just pops out, casually grabs it. So now Jkaem looking for a trade. Nice angle, catches that one. But Spyleader again, consistent, is going to be able to hold behind White Box and pick up the trade to that kill. Takes down Jkaem, and now it's just two left alive from G2 in this 2-on-4. Still very little progress being made on taking control of this map as well. Dennis down to 49 HP. And we can see Fox trying to work his way back out over here to find that kill onto Spyleader. But he's going to fall back safely back over here towards the CT spawn. Work his way a little bit closer towards the A site. And at this point, of course, just closing out those final couple kills. NKL picks up Dennis, and now Fox also getting a drop by NKL as he re-peaks it. And there we have it. E-Frag tying things back up at 4 points now.
Yeah, the expected outcome when you look at the weaponry at the start of the round. But G2 Kinguin, I feel like maybe they need to aggress on A or B just outright. You know, we've already discussed, you did bring this up, and very rightly so as well. The E-Frag are putting a lot of their players in the mid. Like, a lot of their attention is on mid. I feel like a fast push may catch E-Frag off guard here. But G2 Kinguin instead just playing it passive. They're waiting for the potential counter boost to come up after that Molotov. And it won't be forthcoming from E-Frag. So again, this is going to be a close, very slow, probing kind of round for both teams.
And then he's going to come in a little bit deeper there. Just goes off for the boost spot. And we can see some decent damage being done once again. But Dennis, patient as always, moves in, catches that kill in a spider this time. And they're just going to flush their way back out over here towards middle now. Viktor's going to hold things from the sandbags. Picks up one more kill. Gets the intel on this push moving in. But at the same time, Squeaky's going to be a factor too. Dreamer's peeked out. Could use the support of Jkaem, but not even going to need it. Rain finds the one top there. Takes him down. NKL finding a trade as he peeks out. Not going to get a second one, but he does bring one player down a lot lower. Now it's just going to be Bubble though holding up. And Maikelele comes through Z, shuts him down. And that's a clean sweep from G2.
That's another way of doing it. Me saying, you know, maybe they're going to push a site aggressive and try and just absolutely blitz onto A or B. If you get the entries in mid, it simply ceases to be an issue. And that was a fantastic opening pick from the boost. From there on in, G2 Kinguin just stamped down their authority through mid. E-Frag go for the force. It's going to include two FAMASes, only one defuse kit, and a few grenades to play with. So G2 Kinguin with the AWP looking to make something happen. That smoke is going to keep Maikelele at bay for now. He's just going to hold on the right side, make sure that no pesky CTs push through, and try and make the most of that position.
Viktor here again, sitting behind the sandbags. I believe he has a supportive bubble from inside of the vents too, and that's indeed the case right now, as he's just sitting in there waiting, but that's spotted by Dennis. It's going to be able to take him down. Viktor finding a trade once again from that sandbag spot, but Maikelele takes out Spyleader. He overpeaks by a very big margin, and Dennis is going to roll, and he shuts down Viktor as well. So another clean sweep. They just roll in the middle, take full control of it. They're not actually going to proceed up highway just because A is a bit of an unknown at this point, so they're going to instead move in inside of Checker here. Dreamer's going to pop out, finds one kill, can't get a second as Rain takes him back down, and now it's just NKL stuck way over here on the A site.
And this is where the house of cards could start to crumble down, start to fold for E-Frag, because not only are they going to lose this round, their economy is in ruin, and G2 Kinguin seemingly starting to find their form again, where they started off on Dust 2, they're just landing every single shot. Rain was stepping up, being an absolute monster, and so here he comes again on cash, 10 for 5, E-Frag desperately trying to hold on to this last weapon to just give them something to work with in round 11.
He's got a lot of
judging.
Go ahead.
Sorry, go ahead.
I was going to say he has a lot of utility sitting behind that rifle as well.
Yeah.
So that's basically a full buy. He hasn't done anything this round. He basically has a fresh buy coming into this next one if he can save all this.
Absolutely, yeah. It doesn't seem like G2 Kinguin were too interested in actually chasing him down, even though they've got quite a lot of funds to play with, which is quite surprising to me. But regardless, NKL, as you said, plenty of utility, and the M4 will be moving through now to round 11. It's going to be interesting to see if E-Frag go for something different here, if they stack him on a site and the rest of the players push elsewhere. Let's see how this one plays out.
So that is indeed really going to be the only thing that they have going into this round for the members of E-Frag. G2, back up to AKs. They've even got the op in play once again now from Fox as well. So this could be an interesting turn of events considering it was absent for the entirety of that last map from the side of G2. And now we can see good flash. They're going to try to roll back in here. Bubble's going to get dropped. Rain taking them both down there too. And Dennis moves in. He finds a third kill. Picks up the fourth. Just the casual cleanup essentially. And even NKL fails to pick up a single frag with that rifle. All five stay alive from G2. And that is an extremely clean sweep once again. Now they're going to lead by three. And probably going to be able to grow it a little bit more if they come out on top here with this gun round once again. As the utility from E-Frag going to be very, very limited.
Yeah, it seems like some of the trolling nature that G2 Kingdom were going for in Inferno has kind of ceased. Like, they've got their game caps back on again. You know, all systems go. Some of these entry frags have been sensational from G2 Kingdom. There's nothing really E-Frag could have done differently. So you can see them mixing it up now. Three players over on the B side. And to start off with, if the rush comes in, that's great setup. But secondly, it allows them to push through right now and get some information. However, the call that came through, this is probably an A play as the smokes descend onto the site. NKL on the quad is the key man here. One frag's not good for two, however. And now Jacob is there. He gets traded out by Viktor. He'll be a bit disappointed with that result, but Maikelele steps up to the plate and delivers the fatal blow. Bubble chimes in onto the site. 3-on-2 in the CT's favor.
Maikelele taking a whole lot of damage as well, so this is not going to look very good. And especially with Maikelele playing this as aggressively as he is, that's going to be easy pickings for Spyler now. Rain looking for one, but not going to be able to find it. Dreamer shuts him back down. And E-Frag picks up yet another round, striking back. They yet may have a chance to take the lead here by picking this one up, but they still have another gun round to go through here on the side of G2, including the op going into Dennis, but that may get traded out to another player. No, it looks like he's going to keep it, actually.
Yeah, he was using it in some of the earlier rounds on the T side as well, which is always surprising to me, because when you think of the all-pro G2 Kingwin, you're thinking of Maikelele, you're thinking of Fox, but we saw both of them using it on the previous maps. So, Taff Dennis using it. Very, very interesting. He's landing some pretty key frags. He's currently 9-6. Still the top fragger on either team is Rain, who is sitting on 12-6. So, is Dennis going to be able to get the first pick? The answer is a yes. Onto Bubble. That's a huge frag. Beautiful flashbang there from Victor. You can see that Jacob could not see anything. He is very much a dead man. 4-4. And three players from E-Frag stacked on the A side. They have to quickly get a move on and maneuver themselves towards mid.
Maikelele moving in, sitting just underneath this smoke, hoping to catch a nice little headshot there on a Viktor or somebody else, but the pop flash is going to come out. Maikelele actually goes wide out in the open, so it takes a bit of a risk there, but it's to regroup and move their players inside of the vents once again, as I think they may be switching up the play to head into the B side instead. Either way they go, pardon me, they're going to have to deal with two players from the side of E-Frag, so they've got to make this choice soon. 40 seconds, a decent amount of time to make it, but the time getting lower and lower here, they're unfortunately going to run out of it very quickly. So they do move inside of the vents. They're going to go for this. They still keep one player just to drive a wedge between the defenses, essentially. And as they work their way in, checking the default spots, but it's going to be Dreamer that picks up the first kill. Tries to drop down to find a second one, but Maikelele's there to cover it this time. He's going to take him down. They work their way in. The smoke is back over here, so the CT main player, SpyLeader, can't pick up anything. And Fox in the flank actually picks up a kill onto NKL too as he attempts to come back down towards Highway. So they're going to pick him up. There's an attempt to move in from SpyLeader there to just come directly in from CT main, but that doesn't work out very well, and just like that, it's all on Victory. Kills one with an 8, looks to do a second one, and he gets it! Now looking for the third, but it's not gonna happen. Fox saves the day for G2, and they're gonna pick up their 8th point.
Way close to the needed to be, though, from G2 Kingwin. Alright, that was so super close. That's gonna force Jacob onto a Tech 9 in armor instead of an AK. That being said, E-Frag are in no fantastic position themselves. They go for the force. And that... I don't know, man. What's your take on that force? For me, that's a bit sketchy. I'd almost prefer them to just save this round and go for a better buy next.
Well, I mean, I would completely agree with that, because the next round's going to be the final round in the half anyway, so it's sort of like, you know, it's usually typical to save on the 14th and go for the buy on the 15th, but this is just all in, I think. And you can see how aggressively they were playing it, too. There was sort of a strategy behind this, or a method to the madness, essentially, as they were going to try to force it up and catch G2 off guard, but that hasn't really worked out very well for them at all. I mean, they tried to do this a couple times back on Dust 2 as well, and it just didn't pan out. So they try to go back to this, hoping it's going to work on cash, but it's not the case, and now they've kind of screwed the pooch, and we could be looking at a 10-5 half more than likely.
That's it, exactly. Now, if they save in that last round, just get a couple of upgraded pistols. If you want to get CZs, that's fine. In this round, they'd be able to get FAMASs, M4s, maybe even a glass cannon AWP if they so choose. Like, they'd have a much better opportunity of finally getting that 6th. I mean, don't get me wrong, still with these kind of pistols, if they hold the close angles and G2 makes some fundamental errors, they can still pick up this round, but for me, you're just almost hampering yourself, you know, you're almost putting one arm behind your back here from E-Frag. And again, this could be another 10-5 scoreline, and this, if you remember back on Dust 2, is how G2 Kingwin started that as well. Ended up taking it 16-13 in the end.
So, already some damage being done here. Bubble slowly burning alive, but is able to work his way out. He doesn't even get the kill either. It's going to be Viktor that grabs it, but he's going to take the glory of that AK there off of the hands of his teammate. Fox, in the meantime, Having a good old time there, picking up a kill bubble. Now with that, AK actually goes in and finds the trade here. And NKL, great peek, is going to find another one on the Jkaem as he takes him back down. Just Dennis and Rain left alive here from the members of G2. We can see these guys working their way up. There's spyleadeR, lines up a great angle. And just like that, I'm actually wrong. Probably looking at 9-6 now, as this 1-on-4 is going to be leaving all the pressure from G2 in the hands of Dennis here, trying to push this out.
Oh, that was a nice shot. From Dennis. Domed him in midair. And you did end up being wrong, but I feel like your logic was correct there, Blue. I stand behind what you said 100%. Like, E-Frag should not have won that round. There's some fantastic shots. G2 maybe pushed a bit too aggressively, didn't check all their corners. But 9-6 is still a solid T-half. Yes, it's one of those maps. Again, it's like an 8-7 either way kind of map, in my opinion. I think it ebbs and flows, but 9-6 is a really good half. That being said, E-Frag, they've shown great tenacity in the previous two maps and they look dead and buried. I'm expecting more of the same here.
Also, that that model bug that you guys were seeing before, where you were seeing Bubble, I believe, as a T. Hopefully that should fix itself when we switch sides. If not, I can probably try to do a quick reload into the server when we're between rounds. Because I know that was throwing a couple of you off if you haven't seen that before, but that's a fairly common bug with GoTV relays. But again, G2 now having the lead that we predicted them to have. The quick question is going to be, you know, how solid is that CT side jumping onto things? It's kind of been back and forth. We saw back on the last map that it was, or the first map actually, we should start there. It was sort of the T sides that sort of dominated who ended up taking the lead, and then it switched itself back over on Inferno. Somewhat predictably, but a little bit strangely when you consider the first map's results, that it ended up being the CT sides once again that tried to dictate who ended up winning a lot of the rounds there. But now on this one, it looks like it might be going back to the old roots. So if E-Frag come back with the same sort of problems that they were having back on Dust 2, then it could be a quick closeout from G2.
Oh yeah, definitely. They have all the advantages in their hands right now. Now on CT side, E-Frag though, we've already discussed that their T-sided strats are pretty special and like really, really solid. So I'm not necessarily going to count them out just yet. But again, this pistol, utmost importance for both teams. Like, it still hangs in the balance right now. If E-Frag win this, they're right back in it. You're expecting a 9-9 scoreline, then game well and truly on. Rain, though, we've already discussed this before. G2 King win a fantastic, a phenomenal pistol side. They are ridiculous when it comes to pistols because every player on their side has crazy aim. Very difficult team to beat when it comes to pistol rounds.
We can see Dreamer, he's going to get boosted back up here, trying to see if they can catch anything at the edge of this, but they haven't actually explored what's going on in the middle just as of yet either, so it's a little bit of an unknown to them in terms of what exactly is setting here for the members of G2. They're going to roll out. They do manage to spot one, nothing behind the sandbags, but they don't know this as of yet, so they're going to take their time a little bit here, but as they work their way up highway, that's going to be Dennis shutting down one, finds a second one, looking for the third, but finally Dreamer catches the trade. The damage has already been done, though. They know that this push came out towards the middle. They know the bomb is here as well. It's going to work its way in events, but they're going to see this coming from a mile away. They've also got Jkaem sitting behind the box there, too. Hasn't peeked out just yet, but now he's going to do so. SpyleadeR did find a kill, but Jkaem shuts down the final two and gets the clothesline. Third kill there to shut things out. That's G2 now winning at least four out of the last four pistol rounds. I don't remember exactly what happened on Dust 2, but on both this map and back over on Inferno, they were absolutely flawless in taking them.
Yeah, exactly. And even though they won the pistol rounds on Inferno, they still lost the map. And that really does show you a great deal about that map and how E-Frag played. Four P90s. The amount of... Oh, the amount of cringe right now.
The noise.
Now. Yeah, the pro level is over 9,000.
Especially considering the stack that might end up happening here if they move off of middle, so...
Just expect a lot of bullets and faces, guys. Things are about to get real. And they're going A as well. Oh, I can't watch Blue.
Oh god, here they go. There's Maikelele going crazy. Dreamer does get one nice little flick shot there, but Dennis shut down two more directly after this, and that's a quick closeout. Pro 90s dominating the game there. As we do see G2 picking up a swift second round here in the second half. New meta. Watch.
I actually did look away from my screen there. The humanity. It was sad times. Rip in peace, E-Frag. Force buy as well. Interesting.
All right.
Force buy in the third round. I'm not so sure, man.
I think they want revenge, man. I was a bit cheeky, as the British would say. Or maybe not.
We do indeed.
I don't really know. So Dennis fights the opener. Mate. Bubble gets the trade over here onto Fox once again. But Dennis looking for more. Behind that kill, actually. Gets into a little bit of a duel with Dreamer. And Dreamer a little bit over-aggressive. Does not decide to fall back. Victor, in the meantime, this is a very confusing round. Players all over the place at this point. But G2 still kind of hold the cards in their hands. There was one upgrade picked up by Bubble, but he's only got 5 HP. So it's not like he's going to be able to do too much with it. Jkaem rolls out. He takes the same HP traded back, though. Down on 25. And this is the Alamo for Bubble. But Maikelele is going to be able to come in and finish him up with the P90. And SpyleadeR picking the gun up off of his teammate's corpse. Now going to see what he can work. He actually might be able to just roll an A and get the plant. So considering what they got in this round, that could actually be very good. But we'll see how this duel comes out. Takes down Maikelele. And now indeed is going to be able to get the plant here to try to hold off this 1v2. And a decent amount of utility sitting behind it as well. So this is fairly plausible that he could pull this off.
You live by the sword, you die by the sword, and that's exactly what G2 Kingdom are finding out right now. On the receiving end of this P90, this flash could be beautiful from spyleadeR. He goes for a second, it actually bounces off the back wall. I think that's off the crane, in actual fact. And the ladder's big. Dennis gets the spray with 2 HP. He is going to have just about enough time to defuse as well. What a great effort, though, from E-Frag in the end.
I think I could be wrong, but I think he ran out of ammo on the P90, because he like stopped
Very
shooting
possible.
Right before he died. I didn't actually, because my ammo counter was broken, I think, but I'm pretty sure he like ended up running out of bullets there just before he killed him, so one more bullet might have done the job, but it doesn't end up happening, and we do see G2 just barely coming out on top there. But I mean, it's good, because, you know, they go for this Tech 9 round. This gun round's gonna hurt, because as we discussed before, that was two forces in a row that they went for, so they're gonna be stuck on Galils and whatnot here, and very limited utility once again going into this round. But they've done the damage to G2's economy, so if they can win it out with these Galils, then they're gonna be rewarded in a very big way for that.
Oh yeah, absolutely, and if they win it clean as well, they can just pick up the weapons from the corpses of G2 Kingwin. They can even take the AWP if they need it, so a lot of opportunities the Bulgarians, but can they capitalize on those opportunities is the question. 6 rounds behind. They've came back from worse already today, so you can't write them off on that case alone. But they have already chunked through a fair amount of their utility. They've only got 2 smokes to play with, just a few flashbangs and a HE, and a minute to play, and Dennis is managed to move himself all the way up around the back. Edwin looking for a second, can't get it done, but that's vital information gathered on top of the frag that he picked up.
The unfortunate thing, though, is that they spot the bomb, but they don't really spot it being committed to either side just as a bit. If it was inside of AMA, it could have been a different story, but happening back out here outside of the garage is not really going to allow for any sort of big rotation. Now that it's moving into A main, and since there's been a bit of a delay and they haven't heard any noise back over there on B, they can start to figure things out now, so they're going to slowly rotate more players back over towards mid, and there's Maikelele getting the confirmation. He picks up 1 kill over here on a Dreamer. Now there's going to be more rotating their way in here. Fox actually still sticking on B for the time being, but Jkaem catches this kill in middle. The bomb has moved in, but nobody's caught it as of yet, and spyleadeR here, he's going to pick up 1 kill. Rain finding another one. MKL picks up one, and a second back over here shuts down the defenses, but unfortunately, again, he's now going to be the final player left alive versus Fox, and he's only got 11 HP to clutch this out. Fox even knows this too. He's got the pistol out. He just wants to finish this off, and he's going to do it with class. Takes him down with the P250, and that's going to be G2 picking up another point.
Yeah, really smart as well. I know it seems like a very small, insignificant thing to pull your pistol out there, but not only does it allow you more room for errors, probably a call came across that NKL was low as well, so smart that he doesn't come around there with the AWP. Some AWPers would do that. They'd rely so heavily on the AWP, and then if you miss, you're screwed. So intelligent play from Fox, lands the shot, gets the round back for his team. And now another force comes in from E-Frag. Maikelele is lurking in the shadows, and he struck. Oh, Viktor actually gets the frag on terrain. He was just chilling by the barrels, minding his own business, when a spray bullet takes him down. Dream with a fantastic entry frag onto Dennis, who's trying to scamper his way up highway. 4-on-2, bomb planted. E-Frag refusing to lose.
Fox has got himself to highway here, boosting himself a little bit, looking for a bit of a peek coming out from Red on the right side, but not going to find it. Jkaem gets some info, but again, can't pick up the kill, and the team flash comes in there. It does give him some room to maneuver back over here to get himself behind Forklift. He's going to wait for the pop from Bubbles, but completely misses his chance. Fox finds 1 kill, but it's traded out, and now Jacob's stuck here. Dreamer's going to find both of the final kills, and E-Frag now finally get a round under the board for themselves here in the second half, bringing things up to 7-13. Again, it's a bit of a long road to go to get themselves back into this map, considering where they started off from. They're 6 rounds behind at this point, but still, as we said before, G2 never really were given a chance to stabilize their economy, so they're immediately going to get thrown onto an eco round here, or sort of an eco round. They'll at the very least be able to get the pistol upgrades with armor behind it, but still, comparatively to what they're rolling with before, it's a lot less and a lot easier to deal with from the side of E-Frag.
Yeah, they fully committed into this site here, Blue. They have very little funds to back this by, so E-Frag could be good for another 2 rounds, and this is all off the back of the last 2 rounds that G2 Kingwin won. They only kept a player alive. So that's 2 players alive in 2 rounds. That's why they're into this economic situation. And with E-Frag picking up the first frag as well, it's looking super good for the Bulgarians. They could even pull this back to 13-10, and then game is well and truly back on. I'm not going to get too ahead of myself, though, because G2 Kingwin still have 4 players, including 2 Deagles, 2 5-7s with armor, and 2 flashes, so they can go for those cheeky pop flashes into A main if they so choose. And here we go, that's what's going to happen. Although it doesn't really pay off, Dennis gets picked off there. Did get information onto Dreamer, but that's only half the battle because Dreamer comes back in for seconds, lands another frag, and only 2 players remain for G2 Kingwin.
Viktor even chilling here right now. If we do see Jkaem coming back outside of Z, that nade should be perfect. Brings him down to 64 HP. They've got him spotted in there, so they know he's in there. That's a great job being, just in terms of the intuition there coming out from E-Frag. So spyleadeR is going to be able to close him out. And now you've only got Rain, and Rain obviously a decent investment. It's not going to be the worst idea in the world to save, because they're going to be on an eco in these next runs anyway. So he's just going to sit back, look to maybe find a kill or two, but most importantly, look to save this, this 5-7 with the armor sitting behind it.
I think really Rain is hoping that someone runs into his crosshairs and can get a couple kills down and put some more damage onto E-Frag, but that really is best case scenario. As you can hear, the bomb is about to explode. Bubble just keeping on the site on the off chance that Rain went for the cheekiest of ninja defuses, but actually Rain has been spotted and has been fragged. Solid round, G2 King Gwyn, no money to play with, have to eco, and this actually could be double eco territory.
It's going to be very, very low indeed here for G2 now. They've opened up a fairly large gate for E-Frag to get themselves back into this game now after going for that bit of a forced eco. And now they're going to be stuck on two very, very low invested ecos potentially here unless they want to go for a very light rifle round on the 23rd. But for this one, should be a walkover for E-Frag for the most part unless we see some very impressive work with those default and P250s coming out from G2. They're going to line up for a take coming in through A main. It's spotted very early by G2, so they are going to rotate all five of their players into this site. But keep in mind here, E-Frag have not committed to this at all as of yet. So if they spot even a hint of trouble, they can easily turn this right back around and head over to B.
That's a key thing, as you were alluding to before. This really is E-Frag's round to lose, right? Like, everything should be going their way. They've got the map advantage in the sense that the stack is coming in. Of course, they don't know this, but there's a pretty good opportunity and a pretty good chance to call this play. Secondly, when it comes to weaponry, there's only one clear-cut winner here, and the bomb is now snaking its way onto that B-side.
And this was all Bubble, too. Bubble's been over here scouting back B. Hasn't even heard anything at all happening here, so I think he's called this as they definitely all rotated, or at the very least, or at the very worst, there's going to be like one to two players here, so this should be easily managed by us. So they're just going to go for the take here instead. Again, G2, jerk rotating, but again, they're already off-site. The plant's going to come in. It's smoked off, so the odds are not looking good. I imagine they're kind of going to throw themselves at it to see what they can find, but probably won't end up being that much. Maybe a kill or two here, but that's probably the best-case scenario here for these players, and so far not finding a single one. It's down to Jkaem, back down with a USP, and he's kind of stuck here as well, looking to pop out. Even taking the silencer off, man, he's going to try to close out this round with style, but they're not going to want to challenge him. They're sitting back, and looks like he's going to roll back into the site maybe just to throw himself away.
Nice shot from MKL. There we go. 13-9. Let's look at that economy now for G2 Kinguin. They can force up a buy, but it is not great at all. No warps in play. Not a huge amount of grenades. Zero defuse kits. This is rough. It's better than I originally expected. I was expecting maybe even a double eco to come in. A couple players were on 1.6k. That's not the case, but this is not fantastic at all. And Rain's been tagged up as well, down to 80 HP, make that 65, he's just eating damage over and over again in mid. See a pretty heavy mid stack here from G2 King, with a lot of two players over on highway, so they can easily wrap themselves onto the A side if needs be. But E-Frag, again, they're playing this one passively, they're waiting for the aggression to come through from G2 Kinguin. This is what we saw them doing a lot on Inferno, it's one of the reasons they ended up winning that map.
Fox is going to push himself over there towards Squeaky and finds an opening kill once again. That's going to drop Bubble. Dreamer finds the trade over here on Immaculata, though, as he's, for some reason, sort of way out in the open there. I don't think he timed that smoke correctly, so he sort of leaves himself out to die for the most part there. At the very least, he wanted to take the duel, but the T's end up coming out there, so they're going to line themselves up for a push at A now that they've found a successful frag. Dennis has moved out, but NKL, this could be an easy frag for him. He pops out, can't catch it, though. He's retreated back over here to Forklift, and now Dennis is going to pick that one up. Rain finding another one here, too. They're getting mowed down at this point. Viktor found one more, but Dennis just picks up an additional kill, and that's going to end it very swiftly. Now G2 back on the treadmill at this point. There's a lot of money left to still work through on the T side of things, but you have to remember just how close G2 are, and this is harking back to a lot of what we saw in Dust 2 as well.
Yeah, that's it in a nutshell. E-Frag will be able to buy until the end of this map. If it does go the way of G2 Kinguin, if it's 15-9, E-Frag will have another solid buy up. But that's definitely going to worry them a tiny bit as they push through their bubble. Didn't actually get any tags with that AK spray down. That is a missed opportunity. You'd have been hoping for at least a frag, or a lot of damage on both players, but landed nothing.
G2 have completely underestimated what's here, though. They pushed Jkaem back up there in defense, thinking the play's going to be coming from it, but that's not it at all. They're all coming in through the back B hall, so they've already lost two players in the way, and Dennis is going to drop, but they've got this covered now. He's going to move in, finds one kill, a lot of health pool loss, but he finds a second, tries to transfer the spray into a third, but it's not going to happen, and Rain completely whiffing this spray. He's going to get dropped by MKL. Now we can see Maikelele getting up on top, but he too is going to get dispatched by Bubble. A little messy by E-Frag, but they do come out on top due to a missed call from G2, and E-Frag again strike right back. This resets the economy for G2. They might have enough to force, but to be honest, again, with the money they have, it might be worth it to save and try to go for a gun run on the 26th instead.
Absolutely agree with you, 100%. This is a cast iron eco right now. It has to be. There's no other opportunity, no other choice here for G2 Kingwin. If they go for the force, that could actually throw the entire map. So they know this. They're going to go for the eco with just Jkaem, I think, has some armor behind his name to equalize that economy a tiny bit. Still on $2,000, he'll have enough for an M4 and a potential Kev lot. But yeah, I agree with you. I think they underestimated the B play. Although Bubble didn't get frags, it was a lot of information as well. This is something that I didn't mention, I really should have, that he got a lot of information there. He knows two players in check, and he can call out to the rest of his team. They can then throw in the Molotovs, the grenades, and draw out those CT players to then execute them. And that's pretty much what happened. So a solid round for E-Frag, nonetheless.
He was also the only player peeked out of that time, too. I didn't have the camera on it, but looking at it, you could see he was actually the only player that the members of G2 spotted, which is why they might have been thrown off and think it was a more default play. Anyway, the action's going to get started here in this round, and so far, of course, E-Frag just sort of ripping through it at this point. Three kills to none being traded back. Jkaem holding strong in the default plant spot, but gets a clothesline there by NKL. And now it's just Fox, unfortunately, on the B site and in the back B halls as well, so completely detached from the action that's going on. And now, kind of just going to sit in the corner, hope he can find something, but kind of a futile existence at this point in the grand scheme of things.
Oh, you got all morbid on me there. I'm thinking about the meaning of life. That's pretty much what Fox is doing. It's all he can do right now.
It's not like he could exit or anything. They're not going to come meandering into B-site, and why would they hunt him? He's got a P250, so...
Exactly. But I don't know, man, if we fast forward into the 26th round and Fox picks up an ace with a P250.
Then I'll be... My jaw will be wide open, but...
So, E-Frag, keep all players alive. Their economy continues to tick forward. It has been strong for quite some time now. Two players over 10k, as you can see there, Bubble and Dreamer, quite comfortable. And now G2 Kingwin will get the buy, but... It's very reminiscent of that. I think it was round 24 when they went for a buy. Yes, they've got M4s. Yes, they've got grenades, no defuse kits, and really sketchy. So this may force Dan into playing aggressive to get some information, knowing that they can't play the long game. They can't isolate those sites with the smokes that you'd like to do on a CT side. And there we go. They are going to play aggressive at NKL. Beautiful spray down control. Two players in quick succession.
Takes them both down. Now the gates are wide open here. You've only got one player left to defend things from the side of G2, and it's going to be Dennis. He's watching out for the push. In the meantime, they're still keeping their other avenues open too. Fox thinks this is an all-in play into that A site, but there's been no action moving in, so he blindly pushes the back B halls, and sitting inside of useless room, you got Bubble. He picks up an additional kill here. This round's basically over at this point. You've got Jkaem and Dennis both at completely separate sites. E-Frag know that, again, they're probably going to be split, so they just take their time in case they're trying to get aggressive, as they've already seen one push in the back B hall, so they don't know what else could be going on in areas like over towards the mid garage. They're just being a little bit more careful. They're going to wait a couple more seconds, but I imagine it'll be a regroup, and then they'll push into the B site here, as it looks like they're moving towards right now.
Oh boy, G2 Kingwin just can't get a break. They're rushed through squeaky. They want the information. Then Kale's just there. Shuts the door in their face, metaphorically speaking, and just wrecks them. Two players left, and G2 Kingwin just want to save these, if they possibly can, but there's still so much time left on the ticker that there's really nothing they can do. 30 seconds, one's about to get planted, and you can see that Dennis is on 9 HP, he's been spotted. We'll get the frag onto NKL, who did all the work at the start of the round with those two frags. And now you can see the E-Frag, like a dog with a bone, just chase it down, get their 12th round on the board, and G2 Kingwin back into a potential eco again.
And they have no choice, they have to let it happen here, so they're going to let E-Frag get dangerously close to tying up with them at this point. Some upgraded pistols coming out, they can afford to do this. But beyond this, if they went for anything else, it would be very, very risky indeed. So just that P250s, Deagles, 5.7s, CZs, and a default. It's basically a smorgasbord of pistols at this point for G2. And Victor even going to spot the feet of one of them. That's going to be Maikelele, dropped down to 44 HP. Can't kill him as of yet, but Bubble just lining him up. Looking at 1, 2, and 3. Beautiful spray control from Bubble, taking them all down. And now already this round's going over. The perfect nade for Bubble, too.
Shuts down Maikelele. 99 damage or something.
Well, he was already down to 40. That one did about 30.
Oh, was he?
Yeah.
Okay.
And then he just finishes him off with the tap there. And that was just Dennis, again, trying to figure out, well, shit, what do I do now?
Pretty much. That's pretty much it. Deagle in hand, but that's it. Still loads of time to play with for E-Frag. They don't have to rush to plant that bomb. They can make sure that the site is secure first. Indeed they will. Checking every corner. The bomb's going to get planted. And now Dennis looking for the exits. 13 to 14, man. This is a lot closer again than I'd have ever expected when we started to get towards... What was it at one point?
I mean, 13, it was like, they had a 6-round lead. It was like 13-7, if I remember correctly.
Yeah, 13-6, 13-7. So from 13-7 to 14-12, soon to be 14-13, this is like Inferno all over again.
So now Dennis actually has been able to brilliantly avoid everybody from E-Frag, but that's kind of because they're all just sitting inside of A main for some reason. They kind of fear him. I don't know why. The best thing he's going to have is that Deagle, but I guess they don't want to test themselves. And there we go. It's the firing squad. And Bubble gets the ace at the end of the day, actually. Takes him down. But another big thing that we haven't actually touched on, apologies, just as of yet here from E-Frag, is just the money, the pure stacks of cash that they're sitting on at this point. Mm-hmm. You've got 4 out of 5 players sitting over 10k, and Bubble's maxed out here at this point, so it's not like he can even buy anything for teammates to bring that money down. They all have full buys going into this one, so they just have far too much money to work with. Kingwin's going to take a risk, and it fails miserably here. Maikelele has to hold off. He can't do so. Dreamer's going to find the opener, and now they've got nobody on this site to defend it. It's wide open, and the plant's already going to be happening here.
Yep, just about to go down. Fox does finally have an AWP in his hands, but is he going to be able to use this? Retaking with an AWP, not the greatest situations to be in, especially when you are outmanned as well. And that is the issue right now. Spyleader lands the headshot, domes rain as he tries to come up highway, and you can see straight away the white flag is raised from D2 Kingwin. Let's save, boys. Let's try and keep these weapons. But Jacob may not have an easy task ahead of him. He's hiding in the smoke. There's the frag that he's going to land. Looking for the second. Can't get it done. And E-Frag cruising again to yet another round. That's going to be 5 consecutively. And the curse continues for D2 Kingwin. And as you mentioned before, with so much money, it's by and large just been AK-47s that E-Frag have been running with. Straight up AK, straight up grenades, no AWPs thrown in the mix. I'm curious if we're going to see that change now. And I guess it's just a case of it ain't broke, don't fix it. If you don't need AWPs, don't use them. Just use the AKs.
Yeah, I mean, they're on a 5-round streak at this point. They've been running away with this, so... There's no real reason to go over towards an AWP where you could potentially throw yourselves off. They haven't been used to working with an AWP. Fox, as we go back over to the CC side of things, Fox thankfully at the very least saves his, so they have that bit of power to work with. But again, we look at his scoreline, he hasn't really been able to do too well with it just as of yet. And I was actually just checking the scores. It's extremely top heavy right now for one single player on G2. Dennis is leading the team 26-18. The next highest fragger is Rain, or apologies, is Jkaem, sitting down at 17, just under 9 kills behind him. So. Definitely a little bit of underperformance coming out from a lot of the G2 players, and it just seems like one player is sort of carrying the weight, so if he goes down, that doesn't leave a whole lot left for the rest of the team to perform that well.
Absolutely, yeah. That's where G2 were having such a phenomenal major, because pretty much everyone was stepping up. You know, Fox had his moments, Rain had his moments, Maikelele was landing shots, Jkaem was, everybody, really. But today, it has just been a case of one player stepping up. Fox was the man on Dust 2 who went huge. Second map was kind of Dennis, and here we go, Dennis again. And it is also a force buy, which leaves G2 Kingwin in a familiar situation. Very few grenades, no defuse kits. And here comes the push, and that's the key frag that Viktor picks up onto Dennis, who's on top of the vent roof there. Rain is going to hold the close angle, picks it off onto Viktor. There's Maikelele. Maybe some last-minute, last-ditch heroics from G2 Kingwin. Rain with a kill there with the FAMAS as well, and it's not looking too good suddenly for Bubble. But he comes in with spyleadeR, and suddenly we're back into another 2v2.
Bomb goes down. G2 trying to find their way back in. Jkaem coming back in over here through highway. Fox as well coming back over by the usual truck angle, but very aggressive with it too. Jkaem messy on the spray, but picks up the kill on the bubble. And now it's Spyler, 12 HP, moving in. Doesn't find that kill as Jkaem saves his teammate's life. They're going to be able to close it out. And finally another round for G2 to set them up to 15 points.
Oh man, that's got to be demoralizing for E-Frag, but they have the economy. They have the dollar bills to cry into. And wipe away the tears with. So this is going to be another great buy-up from them. Do G2 Kingwin have a solid buy-up here themselves? Of course, a couple of those players can drop weapons. It's going to be an AWP in play. Yes, this is a much better buy than I originally thought it could be. So, game well and truly on. It is 1-1, ladies and gents. This could be the final round of this evening. G2 Kingwin just have to win this to take it 2-1. But if E-Frag pull it back, overtime is where we will be heading.
The nade pops down there. It's not really going to connect too much damage. Dennis does take some heat from that AK spray, but in the long run of things, doesn't really mean too much. I don't think they've spotted him coming into here, which could be a big thing, just because of the fact that they sort of called it off as, yeah, we're good, there's no one inside of mid-garage, and if that catches those guys off guard, then that could be a very different story. But he's not going to stick around to test that theory. Does end up falling back over there to the usual position behind sandbags. And for the time being here, not going to be any additional action happening. What is happening, though, is you can note back over there in the back B halls, his Fox has moved all the way out. He sees there's nothing there. So this can call the rotation over towards the A site, as they know with about 90% certainty, it's either going to be pushed into mid and then, you know, four players in events, which is very unlikely, or it's just going to be an all-out A take.
Still a lot of grenades to play with, though, for E-Frag. Two Molotovs. With these two Molotovs, you can draw out quad. You can even bounce one towards Forklift as well, if you so choose. And here we go. They're both going to go into quad, trying to funnel out those players. Fantastic entry frag from Dreamer. And meanwhile, Bubble catches Jkaem, who looks to rotate around the back. It's suddenly a 2v5. This is phenomenal play from E-Frag. It looks like we are overtime bound, unless Fox can pull off the 1v4 clutch of the series thus far. First frag has connected. Pretty sexy flick across to Victor's head. But three more players to find a frag. He's given his position away, so it's no longer going to be a surprise. There's the second one as well. E-Frag don't need to be peeking this. And a third! This can't be doable. He's got a defuse kit. The bomb is planted for Bubble. But he is defusing right here, right now. Fox is going to sticking through the wall. Bubble knows this and lands the shot. We're going to overtime.
Oh my goodness. That was a very heart-stopping round there towards the end, but thankfully Bubble moves in quickly enough to try and stop things there, so that is going to tie it up at 15 points, and we'll indeed move into overtime here. A little bit of a break, I assume, because these players are going to take a couple moments as they've been playing for a while now, but we'll jump right into that there, and that was back and forth again. G2 dropping the ball majorly here on the second half. They're able to make up for it and at the very least get themselves to 15 points, but with the lead they had going for themselves at the beginning of this half, they should have absolutely closed it out, and we should not be sitting in this overtime at this current point in time.
Completely agree with you. This should have been G2 King wins all day on cash. Like, easy peasy. Easy as you like. They had opportunities on Ferno. E-Frag back into this right now. I still feel it's anybody's game, right? I wouldn't even say, you know, G2 King win. They have the experience when it comes to this. They went overtime to EnVyUs and Cluj in the major. The fact of the matter is that today, off these performances, E-Frag could very easily stomp away with this overtime and take this series. I am not going to count them out just yet.
So it's going to be interesting, of course, when we switch that up. And I believe the rules here... I'm trying to remember exactly if they do. I know we had one overtime. So what's interesting about the overtimes here at StarLadder is they actually do 16k starting money instead of 10k starting money, but I believe it's still MR3. So the economy is like going to be a non-issue basically because of the 16k starting money comparatively to like what you're used to with normal overtimes at 10k. So that's actually going to throw a bit of a wrench in the normal strategy making for a lot of these teams just because of that factor comes into play. So these guys can buy like whatever the hell they want for all three rounds too. So even if you drop two rounds in a row where you would normally expect the third round to just be an eco, it's not going to be the case. It actually, unless they go like crazy and buy like, you know, like five auto or something like that, it actually sustains itself to enough of a point where you can buy through all three rounds even if you lose the first two.
Yeah, absolutely. Because on CT side and overtimes, you're always very, very weary of that. You know, if you've got 10k, you can get an AWP maybe once at a push twice, but economy is always something in the back of your mind. So if it is 16k here, then that does definitely alleviate a lot of the pressure on the CT side. And actually, in a strange roundabout way, I'd say that that may very well favor G2 Kinguin. Because again, they have two or three players that can AWP on their team to a very high level. Whereas E-Frag only really have Bubble. We've seen spyleadeR pick it up a couple times, but Bubble himself, for the vast majority of those normal rounds, was using an AK-47. He was not using the AWP that much. So maybe that's a slight, tiny thing that just points towards G2 Kinguin potentially taking this home. But again, it's so hard to call this.
Another thing that, I mean, I brought it up sort of as we were getting towards the end of this half too, but just to resurface it again, I mean, you just look at the score lines for most of G2 here. It's been very inconsistent for a lot of their players, and they're relying on a very heavy top fragger right now, which is Dennis sitting up at 26 frags at the moment. So that in itself is something that they need to try and look at here, is trying to get everybody else a piece of it. You look at the members of E-Frag, it's a lot more evenly spread. In fact, it's almost like in sequence, 23, 22, 21, and then two players at 19. All you're missing is a player with 20 frags. They're all sitting very close to each other, but it's not the case with G2, and you're relying so much on Dennis to pick up these frags that when he goes down, you can almost call the round being over at that point, unless the players just come out with this wild star performance all of a sudden.
Absolutely, yeah. There's a 4... kill difference between Bubble and Victor, or slash NKL on EFRAG, whereas there's an 11 kill difference on the side of G2. If you go from Dennis to Fox, as you were just discussing before, and Fox, the player that really shone for me on Dust2 on both teams. He was the guy that was picking the AWP up and doing craziness all over the board, whereas Dennis has been using the AWP a lot more on the side of G2 Kingo when it came, especially onto the T rounds. He was constantly using that looking for the entries. So we're just currently waiting. The team's kind of discussing amongst themselves a couple of things. Seems like they need another minute, so we could be a little while longer here, Blue. It's been a pleasure casting with you for the first time, though, man. And what a series we had as well to kick it off.
Yeah, man. I woke up with like a... woke up with like a 5-minute warning, like, hey, come cast this game. And I was like, oh, okay. Jumped out of bed, came downstairs, turned on the computer, kicked on the stream, and, well, it's been quite a wild ride here so far for these three maps. So, indeed, it has been a pleasure up to this point. So, again, I think we're just waiting. Oh, wait, both sides should be ready now. So, we're not going to be waiting anymore. We're going to go right into it here. The casual conversation between the teams must now end, as they have to go back to murdering each other here in Counter-Strike Global Offensive. Once again, guys, for those of you that are just joining us, though, this is the StarLadder Star Series Season 14. It's EFRAG versus G2 Kingwin. The set is tied up at 1-1 here in the third and final map, and we're going into our first overtime. It is going to be max starting money, 16k, and indeed, I was actually a little bit overzealous with it, as look at G2's buy.
Oh! Dennis tags Rain in the back. It's not the end of the world, but 19 HP evaporates. But I say it, two auto snipers with the AWP. This is the freedom that 60k allows you. Maikelele goes for the early pick, but he's done this a few too many times. He's trying to do this a lot in regulation time. He got caught then as well. So for me, G2 Kingwin effectively playing themselves out of this round. It's not quite over just yet. There's two auto snipers in play, one of which Dennis is tapping across to Squeaky. But my goodness, G2 Kingwin just gift wrapping three kills across to EFRAG.
What's interesting is they've been doing a good job of tagging these guys with the autos, but they haven't killed them out just as yet. There's going to be Jacob fighting one. Dennis gets the pistol out, kills two in sequence, takes out Bubble and takes out Bubble and NKL, and then just finishes the job by eliminating spyleadeR. Oh my god, that was a huge turnaround right there, and those autos do work.
Well then, just scrap everything I just said. Gift wrapping, frags across, doesn't matter. 2v4, no problem, boys. CZ with two frags, Autosnipe with two frags. How demoralizing must that be for EFRAG? And they're going to run the exact same composition again here for G2 Kingwin in this MR3. Of course, 19 is the magic number here in this first overtime. And it looks like G2 Kingwin are going to be edging towards that much sooner. Fox going for the aggression once more, this time on the B side with the AWP. Bubble is there, laid in wait with his AK-47. So far, G2 Kingwin have held on. Maikelele goes aggressive again. This time he does get the upper hand with the first frag. spyleadeR's down to 6 HP. He can't afford to repeat that. And wisely backs away.
So now we can see, too, NKL just sitting at Squeaky. If he pops out right now, he could have two kills in his arsenal here. But there's an auto covering that. So, yeah, you don't want to peek that. He's going to sit back for the time being, waiting for EFRAG to get themselves into a good spot. But to be honest, you can just look at EFRAG. They're trying to figure out, you know, like, what exactly to do. They're going to go for this mid-take, but those autos are still both in play, still full HP. There's a kill coming out from Jacob as he comes outside of Z. Just going to catch spyleadeR, even pushing through with this now, too. The pop flash comes in. They completely blind Victor. Doesn't it bubble at all, though? But he's going to be careful with this. Now they move out. They're here by White Box. Rain takes out one. Bubble's found the other. But at the same time, the flank has been opened up here, too. So that's going to be the auto now sitting behind the bomb carrier. Couple extra shots than we necessarily could have needed, but nonetheless takes him out. The bomb's now on the floor. And it's just NKL over here, too. He's got control of the A site, but without a bomb, it's not like he can really do anything. And another auto kill comes in to close it out.
This is what we were kind of discussing before. I don't think that EFRAG have three players who are capable of using these kind of weapons. They are much happier when it's going to be the AK-47s. They're trying to fight fire with fire. They're trying to take the AWPs to the auto snipers and the AWPs of G2 Kingwin. A lot of pressure riding on this round for EFRAG. If you lose this, you have to have a flawless CT side to take us into second overtime. There is no room for error. Bubble goes for the peak and he gets taken down from Fox. spyleadeR does answer back onto Dennis. But again, EFRAG are against the ropes.
G2 just super aggressively playing this, dude. It's getting crazy at this point, too. Two players push inside of Squeaky. They're not going to catch anything here. They do decide to fall back off of it, but there was also the aggression here from Fox, too. He's sitting in a useless room right now, having a bit of a duel with spyleadeR, and he's going to swipe him, takes him down, and now this is only three left alive from EFRAG. as the rest of these guys are going to try to work their way in through A main. One coming in through Squeaky, which is going to be NKL, but they're ready for this. Two sitting in quad corner there. There's going to be Maikelele finding one, looking for a second, transfers the spray to get it, and as NKL rolls out, that's going to be Rain to shut it down. A flawless CT-sided half from Kingwin, and now just 1 point away on their T side from closing out this match.
Yeah, and here comes the issue now for EFRAG. Do they have the players that can use the auto-snipers? Are they going to revert into that kind of play style? And additionally, can they hold off to perfection on their CT side now?
They might just copy it, to be completely honest. No, they're still going to stick with rifles. And look,
yeah,
G2.
This is it, man.
This is what I was saying. G2 are just going to use the rifles, the autos rifles that is back over here on this side as well, the T-sided ones, which, I'm going to be honest, you rarely see those come into play.
Indeed. Very, very rarely. But it makes sense in this context because we can just tap through mid. It's basically all tin. You can tap through mid and try and get a bit of damage down. And there we go. The entry frag comes in on Fox, and that is going to be checkered. And it gets wiped clean. Dreamer trying to hold on for dear life. He gets spotted. Does land a frag. SpyLeadeR, meanwhile, is doing work elsewhere. Remember, three rounds needed in a row for EFRAG if they want to take us into second overtime. They've shown great tenacity this evening on a number of occasions, so you can't write them off. And they've started perfectly so far on this CT side. The problem is that Viktor goes re-peeking and gets caught by one of those two aforementioned auto-snipers. Instead, he's going to get this frag. If he gets this frag, it's well and truly back on for G2 Kingwin.
Kale's going to have to hold this like a champ right now. They don't expect him to be here, but they're going to roll right out, trying to kill him with it. But he's going to take one of them down, looking for the second, but he runs out of ammo. So Dennis is going to find the trade. Now, though, it's just Dennis in this one-on-two. Very, very low on SpyLeadeR. 3 HP. All he has to do is take him down. And Dreamer as well, sending it 46. So it's going to be tough, but thankfully SpyLeadeR pops out, gets the off-angle shot, takes him down. We will indeed see the first round being picked up by the members of EFRAG. And finally, those autos are defeated. And we will see G2 dropping one here as well.
They have been dethroned. So, are G2 King are going to go for the same again, or are they going to learn their lesson here? It looks like more AKs are going to be filtering through. Nope, Jacob is going to be using an auto sniper for himself. EFRAG on the other side of the coin, going to be rocking with 4M4s. Bubble? Bubble, please. Don't DC now. Not like this.
Oh, come on.
He's at spawn. Not like this, please.
Oh, back up, back up, back up.
Okay, okay, good.
Hold on. They're calling for it. Oh, this is going to get really awkward, because now I don't even know if this
nice back
matters or not. They agree to it.
Yeah. Okay. I was just thinking, if they lose this way, I can't even imagine the outcry from the CS community.
Yeah, that would have been pretty crappy if the game ended like that. So this round doesn't matter, guys. Just ignore stuff that is going on here, because they're going to back it up here real quick. And then we'll restart this one right from the way it was, but... Thank goodness G2 agreed to that, because that could have been problematic if that happened like after the take started.
Absolutely, yeah. It's going to take a little while here before we get ourselves back into the action, but there we go. Here, sportsmanship continues, and we will have this round going underway. So take two of round 5 of 6 in our first overtime. EFRAG going to be looking to get themselves on, and again, Bubble seems to be chilling at spawn, not buying anything. Please, Bubble.
No, he's here. His internet is not cooperating with him, though.
Ah, okay.
Due to the possible dreaded thing we will not mention here on stream. Trying to see if his ping has gone up at all. No, he's still sitting at 33, so... Looks like he's good. It could just be bad routing, or his internet could be freaking out on him. Because I know Europe has like way more ISPs than the US, so server routing is sometimes an issue for European games.
Mm-hmm. Every time I cast EFRAG, they always have internet issues as well. Like every time about fail. He could get in a lot of loss or choke, of course.
Yeah.
These are other factors that could be coming in.
I imagine it could be a bit of a routing issue that could be dictating this right now. So just waiting for him to settle this. He's gone for buys now, so... Looks like they're calling it off. It looks like they're calling the pause off. That should be. So I think they're good to go. I don't really know. But it's still kind of comical that regardless of now it finally failing on the T side, Jkaem is still buying this auto sniper. We didn't get a chance to touch on that because the round started a little bit too quickly. But now we have plenty of time as he's going to go for this buy again. And I talked about this before about how, you know, because of the fact they start off with 16k money, it's going to be great. But honestly, this might leave him just under enough to go for full buy. He's still gonna have an AK and everything, which again, it's a little bit ridiculous when you think about it in the grand scheme of things, but I guess it works, so just buy up the auto sniper because you're going to have the extra money anyway, so why not if you know how to work with it?
Yeah, and even if he can't afford a full buy, he's got three players who are on 8.6k, so they can drop from him no problems as well. So there's other ways around this, and what Jacob did last time is take it mid, tap through the tin walls and try and get a couple of headshots maybe through there and pick up a frag. This time, not as interesting. He does eat quite a bit of damage from that grenade down to 65. E-Frag again, it's the same kind of scenario for them. You can't afford to lose one of these next two rounds. You have to claim them both. Molotov lands in vent. That's going to force Bubble out into the open. Jacob's looking to capitalize on this with his auto sniper. Spot it. What a headshot that is. He can even peek down to the left and get a second frag onto Bubble, who's hiding behind the smoke. But still, the entry goes the way of G2 Kinguin.
He doesn't see Bubble, though, so Bubble should be able to take him down. And indeed, that's going to be the case. Finds the trade. So the auto sniper is now dead, sitting up on the boost spot for the time being, but the take is on from G2. They're moving into the B site here right now. Dreamer's looking for the response captures. Well, they have no clue he's up there right now, so that's a free kill he gets on a Dennis. And again, remember this before too, Dennis, he's that carry fragger right now, so he's the top player and he's now gone down out of play. So without him, it's gonna look rough for the rest of G2 unless, again, they can perform very well here, but they've got the hold. And now this is the big thing, is getting that retake from E-Frag's perspective of this. Is, again, they actually do see G2 getting pretty aggressive. They move outside of this. They're gonna find the trade to their loss of their teammate, and Rain's gonna come back, and he finds another one here too, but Spyler picks up a kill. Now it's just this one-on-two, falls out of the site. The plant position, not 100% sure as to where it is, but they're gonna move in, and again, that's gonna be an execution coming in there from Bubble, so they'll be able to come out on top of this one. They've got the kit, so they should have enough time, and they will indeed pick up a 17th point.
Super, super close though at the end there. E-bot. Kinguin 34, E-Frag 31. You what, mate? A bit off on the counting there, aren't you, E-bot?
Better, we could be really delayed, and that could be the actual server count right now.
Like 2 hours behind the
You're
actual
like,
score.
Oh, I gotta get some food ordered if that's the case, man, because we're gonna be here for a while.
Well, that's a decent retake though from E-Frag. It was looking bad there when Rain gets the second frag. It's a 2-on-2, but there's just too much aggression. Dreamy goes for the aggression and will get the rewards in the sense of a kill. So Fox is down. E-Frag. Very close to getting their perfect CT half and taking it to second overtime. G2 Kinguin, can they cause the upset now?
Dennis is boosted up here too. Mid's in complete control of these guys. They've got some resistance on highway, but Viktor caught with a nade in his hand, so Jacob's going to take him down. Now that's the even trade. They're back up to four players on each side. No movement from G2, though. They're still sticking in the middle. They're not moving beyond this, just in case we do see the players from E-Frag trying to get aggressive. That's what they did at the beginning of this round, so it wouldn't be too surprising, but that's a great molly that comes out there from Dreamer. Going to completely hold these guys in checkers, and they know it's coming. It's been loud as hell as they came outside of the vents there, so they know it's going to be moving in, but the rotations are still somewhat slow. He hasn't confirmed, because he hasn't popped up as of yet to see just how many are moving in. He wants that kill. He's going to find him, a complete underestimates the push. He thinks it's all the way up on site. That's not the case. Now Spyleader comes in. Dennis is going to miss his off shot, but then switches over to the Tech-9 and casually takes down Spyleader. So now we're in a 2-on-2. Even trades have still been coming out. No bomb plan as of yet here either, but there's 30 seconds left on the clock. NKL patiently waiting, sitting outside, and Bubble's going to move in too. Looking for the op opportunity here to take down the planter, but he's not going to find it. But look at this. NKL moves in, takes down Dennis, and now it's all in Jacob. He's burning alive, and NKL's going to move in. He's going to shut it down. Double OT is what we're going to.
You're absolutely going to double OT. What a fantastic hold of nerve from E-Frag to take the three rounds, to take us into that second overtime. Unbelievable. I really did think that G2 Kinguin probably should have held on in that 2v2. I felt like that really was their round to lose there, but fantastic retake from E-Frag. And again, we're going to have G2 Kinguin on their CT side now. Match stopped by admin.
I think that 35-31 thing messes up the overtime.
Yes,
so
indeed.
I think they have to... Ebot's a little drunk right now. We gotta sober him up. And hopefully reset things so we can actually go into the second overtime. But still, we'll keep it even. And the CT side's dictating basically who wins out these rounds for the most part here. The auto snipers, they look strong going into the second half here for G2. Actually don't work out so well. So as we switch sides once again, the question is now, is E-Frag going to continue doing this ridiculous strat? Or apologies, is G2 going to continue doing this ridiculous strat now that the money gets reset for themselves? Or are they just going to go back down to something normal here to try to pick up some rounds on the T side? And it looks like that's going to be the case finally. They're going to sit back here. Just the op in the hands of Maikelele. Everybody else is going for AKs. No more auto snipers. They've had their fun with that, at least on the T side.
Have indeed. So only two ops on the battlefield this time. Bubble and Maikelele. Everything has came full circle from Dust 2, so he'll be occupying that. It's going to be a push through Squeaky, but just Jacob by himself. For me, again, that's Maybe a bit of lack of communication, a bit of lapse in concentration there from King when you typically want to get the avenging frags on the T side. And NKL is going to get avenged from Dennis. 3v3, rain is pretty low, however. The E-Frag have to spread themselves across the map now and try and guess the right site. And it appears that is not the case just yet. It's going to be on spyleadeR. Looks like they're setting up for a potential A play. Or the boost, in actual fact, from G2 Kinguin. Two players boosted up.
Bubble sitting inside of Z2. He's going to be a big player here, too, and he realizes this is moving in. One more is going to work his way with the bomb to go over towards Squeaky. But for the rest of these guys, they're slowly pushing up middle. Still nothing for Bubble to spot just as of yet. And they've completely evaded him. He still thinks that everything is crystal clear. They haven't made a single sound. But when they throw this nade, he's going to see it. He spots it too. But Dennis, he didn't see him. He turns around. And Bubble's going to take him down. Almost gets the second kill. Lights him up in a very big way, but not going to take him down. SpyleadeR, though, is going to be able to finish him back off. Now we see the plant coming in from Rain, but he's only got 10 HP to clutch this out against Dreamer, who's still at full, rotating in from B right now.
You'd fancy that Dreamer should have this in the bag. Yes, Rain has planted that smoke down, and in actual fact, I'm going to quickly backpedal. I'm not entirely sure you would fancy Dreamer here. I originally thought that he had more grenades than this to entry onto the site with, but he doesn't. Rain is playing this one so smart. He is going to get taken down. But because he's on so low HP, can I expect him to try and play something like that, to try and get the upper hand with a close range encounter, rather than playing long range where one bullet finishes him off. So Dreamer is going to get that, but that was a bit sketchy again. G2 Kinguin, right back to the drawing board.
Rain basically just looking for an off-screen shot there for the most part, trying to use the smoke to his advantage to try and see if he can completely flank him from within it. Doesn't pan out so well, so again, still going to remain flawless on both teams' CT sides here, as E-Frag are going to pick up another point. They'll take the lead off of this, but that doesn't mean anything, at least until we see one team taking like a T round here. It's probably when we're going to see a flip side, and that could potentially mean which team will end up taking the match as well. But there's going to be Viktor. So far, just cleaning up shop here in middle. Takes two kills, one with a nade, one with his rifle. Maikelele gets the trade, but now still, they've lost two of their players. Here comes Maikelele, though. Spot spyleadeR. Should have seen that other one. Bubble, in the meantime, catches Jkaem before he can get himself inside of Z there. So it remains still in the favor of E-Frag for the time being. And as we said before, these players from G2 are still trying to make their way into one of these sites. Rain's going to join up with Maikelele, but with how low he is, he's got to be very careful. Dreamer even shuts him down, and now Maikelele, he can't do anything because he doesn't even have control of the bomb anymore. It's sitting back up in vents.
The only good news for him is it's quite clear that E-Frag don't know where he is. They are pincering round, though, from different angles, and he has just shot out. So now they suddenly know. So here we go. 50 seconds. Can Maikelele pull off a ridiculous clutch? And that's pretty much what's required right now for G2 King with the answer. A resounding no. Sprayed through the smoke. E-Frag now taking the initiative, moving themselves two rounds ahead. And suddenly E-Frag have a real chance at winning this map and indeed the series.
Some great English from Maikelele there in the chat. What did he even say?
Also known as Dunno.
Oh, this team nade! Oh no! So much damage! Oh my goodness! That brings Zedrox out like 20 HP off of almost three players. So there's gonna be Dennis taking down one of them, takes out spyleadeR. And now G2 just take it nice and slow here, as they may very well actually be able to steal away one of these rounds. Oh, that flick from Maikelele. He's going to take one down. Viktor does eventually end up trading him back out, but as they move in, Viktor finding a second. Finally, Rain takes him down, but Dreamer took a kill as well. So it's still, after all these trades going back and forth, it's still going to be an even game right now in a 2-on-2. But E-Frag have been split, and they're calling this rotation incorrectly. And Kale's moving into Z right now, where the take's going to come in for main.
Problem here, though, is even though it's a 2-on-2, zero utility for E-Frag, unless they can pick some up off the corpses of their teammates. Kinguin have every single advantage at disposal. 2-on-2 with the bomb down, forcing the retake to come in from the Bulgarians. Can they get anything done? NKL pushing in first. Jkaem isolated from Rain for the time being while that smoke is down. That could be the determining factor here. Dreamer's going to go in first. Is he going to expect to play here? Oh, I think he just saw the gun barrel peeking through the wall. That is a catastrophe. However, Rain is there to lock it down. Dreamer lands the shot and will clutch this round out. E-Frag are going to go three rounds in a row on their CT side, six in total if you take the last half as well. And now everything is piled on G2 Kinguin. The roles have been reversed, right? Before, it was a case of E-Frag have to win every round to take us to another row of time. Now it's G2 Kinguin have to go and do that.
So, I think they... Wow, they really... We just somehow switched. I just realized this too. We're looking at the top. The surf is really messed up right now. We just somehow switched from MR3 to MR5, and the server still thinks we're on the first overtime right now. So, it's probably going to take a minute to fix that. But again, it still has remained the CT side sort of dominating things at this point. And oh boy, that's not good. And before the chat spams Master Guardian Elite for my rank, because I just got dropped from the server.
I'm waiting for that spam. Let's go.
Alright, it's going to come. You know it's going to come, dude. It happened last time, too, and they, when I was DMG the other day. It was just like, oh, he's DMG! Alright, let's get that server info, because the match is actually probably live right now, so you should probably get back into the game.
I just got kicked as well. I'm waiting.
Alright. We don't have cams to go to, by the way, guys, so we just have our AFK screen, but we should be able to jump right back in.
It's your benefit, guys. You don't want to see my face.
It's back in now. And the game's at 0-0, so I have no clue what's happening at this point. Alright, so it looks like G2 are going to go back to the auto strat now that they've switched sides once again. They're just going to go for this double auto buy-up, along with the op still in play here as well. Dreamer, along with the rest of E-Frag, just going for the normal buy. And we'll see exactly what they can work. And are you back on the server yet?
I am on the loading screen because my PC is a snail. So, I'm back on. There we go.
Alright, there you go.
So, two auto snipers on an AWP. I think you just mentioned this before. It looks as though G2 Kinguin. Oh, they have got the early retaliation frag. They are stacking pretty heavily towards this A side, and that's where E-Frag are coming in here, but we could have another massacre on our hands.
And now they're going to work their way into the site. Jkaem shutting one down with the auto sniper, though. Dreamer finding the response as he takes him back down, so still an even trade now, and into a 3-on-3. The rest of E-Frag trying to work their way back into the site here, but we are going to see Dennis picking up another one with the auto. There's Rain with his rifle as he takes him down, but Viktor catching two. Rain and Dennis both falling down, and now we can see Fox. He's going to move in, trying to find this shot over here onto Viktor to try and take him out of the picture, but as he creeps his way in here, keep in mind, too, if E-Fry clutch this, that's it, but thankfully G2 keep themselves in this, and they're going to win out another round.
Whew, jeez. Yeah, as you say, that's the case right now. You can see at the top of the screen, it only says 1-0. Make no mistake, we're on second overtime. The score, I can't count, so it's going to be hard. All I do know is that G2 Kinguin have to win the next two rounds, otherwise they lose this best of three series. E-Frag have two more chances to close this out. Again, no long-range weaponry for them. They're not going to be using any AWPs or any auto-snipers. None of those shenanigans. It's just 8Ks and just raw entry fragging potential.
And now it's just going to be a straight-up push over here coming into the A site. Maikelele has to hold this, but spyleadeR, he's going to pick up the kill. And here's the big problem for G2. They left this wide open here, but thankfully Rain coming up big, picks up two. Now NKL finding the trade. They're trying to pick up these auto-kills once again. Dennis and Jkaem have to do this, but they're still rotating in. Jkaem finding one, meanwhile, back over here towards middle. So that's going to put them at a disadvantage. But again, they've got the smokes and whatnot. This is going to be a very hasty retake coming in from G2 once again. They try to hold their current positions, and it's working out great so far. Jkaem moving himself back in. Actually trades out the auto. They trade out both of them here, too, going over to rifles. But Jacob's going to get caught off guard. He's going to get dropped. NKL finds Fox, and this could be it right here. Dennis finding one, but he's got to clutch out this one-on-one once again. The flash coming out. He's going to stick this defuse, but doesn't even realize Dreamer's back here, and this is going to close it out. That's it, boys. E-Frag win the match, and they're going to take it 2-1.
Unbelievable. Who would have thought this? The odds were so heavily against E-Frag. We both felt this would probably go 2-0. I know I definitely did. And E-Frag have done it. They come back from a 1-0 deficit as well. The hardest possible way, bringing it back into an overtime on cash, which looked to be going the way of G2 Kinguin, who had like a 13-7, 14-8 sort of lead. Huge upset. Absolutely massive upset there from E-Frag.
And indeed, the post-major sort of drive out there is going to be affecting the gamers too, guys, but they're not going to have a whole lot of time to, they're not going to have a whole lot of time for that, because as the announcement came out today, they're going to be heading to IEM in just about 2 weeks as well, so they've got to shape that right back up if they want to perform there, and indeed, that is going to be our big upset for today. E-Frag will take it 2-1, and I believe that is the only match we'll have on the stream, at least the European one for today. There is going to be a North American stream, guys, a little bit later on today. It will not be myself being on the stream, but it should be Bach and I believe one other person joining him. That's going to start at 10 p.m. Eastern time or 7 p.m. Pacific. I think it's like 4 a.m. for Europe. So if you want to watch that, you can go ahead and tune in right here on this channel. But beyond that, here for the European stream, we are done for the day, guys. So thank you all very much for tuning in. Anything else you'd like to add before we close out, Metas?
No, it's a pleasure. Fantastic game. Hope you guys enjoyed it. And, well, until next time, peace.
All right, guys. Thank you guys once again for tuning in, and we'll see you next time here at StarLadder.